portals interact with mescons, so you can add switches or monitor whether they're turned on. This is a surface portal. You can enable these ones in the Nether mod options. This is the other demo code example portal. It's a platform portal going to the floatlands. Paramat's going to change the way the floatlands are generated, so this is not doing anything smart. It just goes straight up. I should probably change this to be made of something other than ice. I just chose ice because it's a nice blue to go with being a sky portal, but in some mods ice melts, which is probably not great. This is an example of how I'm hoping the Portals API can be used to create game progression. And look what we found, a book of portals. This is going to show us what portals are available and how to build them. The book tells me that the portal stone needed to get to the Hallelujah Mountains can only be found in ancient portals in the Nether. So, we're going to the Nether. Pretend I've just been on an adventure to get some obsidian and mes crystal. Now, I'm going to hunt around and look for one of these ancient portals. Some of this nether sand is dangerous, and you don't want to be standing on it if you disturb it. Ah, that's what we want. The broken ruins of an ancient portal. That's portal stone for the taking. Now we're able to build a portal to a new realm. And we're in Hallelujah Mountains, which is set very close to the ground at the moment. I probably could have just built my way here. It could have been set to generate even higher than the floatlands though.